This one's called Cello. After I learned the guitar, I wanted to buy a cello. My wife wouldn't hear her. Said the cello made all music sound like a dirge. You don't want to play the bloody cello. And that was that. I consoled myself by listening to Rostropovich and Yo-Yo Ma and practicing 12-bar blues chord progressions in the basement. I probably wouldn't have made much of a cellist anyway, given my age and late start. But what about Ned B? Playing the cello on Homicide, Life on the Street, accompanied by a beautiful young violinist and boot. Okay, a real cellist. I taught him how to fake the moves, but I believed in anyway. Ned was so exuberant, so proud. Anything is possible on television. Taylor played the cello in midlife before he ever became an actor. In fact, he followed his teacher to California and was discovered by a talent scout in the best Hollywood tradition. I never thought of Robert Taylor, the movie star, as a real person until I read that footnote long after he was dead. About him playing cello. It was like realizing Paul Newman stayed married to the same woman for 50 years and sold salad dressing and was 5'8" tall. Or that Boris Karloff's lisp was real. That he dropped out of school, worked appropriately as a ditch digger before getting into acting, and organized a benefit in Regina after the 1912 cyclone, standing for all his monstrous stature, only 5'9". Robert Taylor was almost 6 feet tall, but one has to sit